in algebra. So the Boolean algebra was formulated by George Boole. In the previous class we have seen that 0 means off and 1 means off, on. So there are three logical operators based on logical not, logical and logical or. These are the fundamental, you might say it is, these are the fundamental operators based upon that there are many derived operators. So logical not, since logical not accepts only one input, so it has two combinations. The formula is 2 to the power of n. So since it has one input, so 2 to the power of 1 is two combinations. So A and A inversion. So A means 0 and 1, you have to write 0, 1. So 0 will become 1 and 1 will become 0. This is called inversion. Logical not is also inversion, like we did in proportional logic. Then logical AND. Logical AND, basically what, since it has two inputs, so 2 to the power of n is equals to 2 squared equals to 4. So 4 combinations. And in AND, we choose what? We choose that if both of the conditions are true, then only the final output is true. Basically, we can express this in the form of multiplication. So on B side, we are writing 0, 1, 0, 1. On the A side, we have written 0, 0, 1, 1. Now, if you multiply the two individual sides, what is, we know that 0 multiplied by 1 is 0, 0 into 0 is 0, and 1 into 1 is 1. So 0 into 0, 0. Then 1 into 1 is your 1. Since 1 into 1 basically means that 1 means what? 1 means true and 0 means false. So 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0 and 0 into 0 is 0. Since on the last line we are seeing that both of the inputs are true, then only the output, final output will be true. Now for logical or, we are seeing that it is basically addition. So if you so in logical or there is two inputs, so 2 to the 2 square is 4. So 4 inputs. So under B we have written 0, 1, 0, 1, and under A we have written 0, 0, 1. Now if you add it up, ignore whatever you have learned in data representation in class 11, that what we have learned is that 1 plus 1 is your 1, 0. But here in this case, we always remember that 1 plus 1 is 1. Since we are representing in the form of true. Since logical OR is saying that if any one of the input is true, then the final result will be true. So 0, 0 is, if it is both are 0, then the final output will be 0. 0, 1, if any one of them is true, the final output will be true. If any one of them is again true, the final output will be true. And since on the last line we are seeing that both of them are true, so that is why the final output is also true. Now let us construct a truth table. Here we have told to draw a truth table for the Boolean expression. So here we have seen that A plus whole bracket A plus B C, since there are three inputs, so there is n equals to 3. Now 2 to the power of n is equal to 2 cube, so 8 combinations. Now under C we have written A, B, C. So under C we have written 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 8 times. And under B we have written 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. This forms your B side. And under A we have written 4, 0 and 4, 1. Now we will approach by breaking into sums. So always remember that, always try to solve from within the bracket. Okay, so first one is A into B. So A into B means basically A and B. So we have learned that if both of them are true, then only the final output will be true. So from here to here, for the four lines, any one of them is false, right? Since any one of them is false, we have written 4 zeros. And after that, there is again 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. 0, 1 means is basically those are true, and 0, 0 is basically means false. So since we have learned in AND that we will multiply. So 1 multiplied by 0 is 0. 1 into 0 is again 0. 1 into 1 is 1. And 1 into 1 is again your 1. Now AB plus C. So AB, so 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is your 1, 0 plus 0 is your 0, 0 plus 1 is again your 1, 0 plus 0 is again your 0, 0 plus 1 is your 1, 1 plus 0 is your 1, and 1 plus 1 is your definitely 1. Then it is complement. Complement basically, what you are going to do is that if it is 1, it will become 0, and if it is 0, it will become 1. So 0 will become 1, 1 will become 0, 0 will become 1, and so on. And for the last one, that is a plus whole bracket ab plus c whole complement. So basically meaning that, so we will just add the values of a with ab plus c whole complement. So 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 is your 0, 0 plus 1 is your 1, 0 plus 0 is your 0, 1 plus 1 is your 1, 1 plus 0 is your 0, so 1 plus 0 is your 1, and again 1 plus 0 is your 1, and finally 1 plus 0 is your again 1. Try to solve this truth table on your own. Okay, I will supply the answer in the next video. Okay, now we will go through the postulates of Boolean algebra. The first postulates of Boolean algebra is properties of 0 and 1. So you are seeing a plus 1 is your 1 and a into 0 is your 0. So a under a is 0, 1 and under 1 is 1, 1. So a plus 1 is your 1 and a plus 1 is your 1. So let us analyze. So 0 plus 1 is your 1 and 1 plus 1 is your again 1. So you are seeing that the result of a plus 1 is same as the 1. So that is why a plus 1 is your 1. And again a plus a into 0 is 0, 0. So a 0 a into 0. So under a I have written 0, 1 since there is only one combination. Since there is only one input, so 2 to the power of 1 is 2 combinations, so 0, 1. And under 0 is 0, 0, double 0. So let us multiply 0 into 0 is 0, 1 into 0 is again 0. So how to solve this? A into 0 is 0. So if let us multiply 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 into 0 is again 0. So the value of A into 0 is identical as 0. That is why we are saying that A into 0 is your 0. Then a plus 0 is your a. So a plus 0 is your a. So let us analyze. So under 0 we have written double 0 and under a we have written 0, 1. Now if you add it up, a plus 0, so 0 plus 0 is 0 and 1 plus 0 is again 1. And for a 1, a into 1, so we are basically seeing that the value of a plus 0 is same as a, that is why we have written a plus 0 is equal to a. We have to learn these formulas by heart, because you cannot, without knowing this formula, you cannot solve or simplify the harder problems, which we will discuss in the upcoming videos. So a into 1 is your a. So under a we have written 0, 1 and under 1 we have written 1, 1. So a into 1, so 0 into 1 is your 0. 1 into 1 is your 1. So the value of a into 1 is same as a. That is why I have written a into 1 is equal to a. Complementary laws. So under complementary laws, a plus a bar is equal to 1. So how it is occurring? Under a I have written, since there is only one input, so 2 to the power of 1 is 2 inputs, 2 combinations. So 0, 1. So a complement will be 1, 0. So 0 will become 1 and 1 will become 0. So a plus a bar, so 0 plus 1 is 1 and 1 plus 0 is your 1. So the value of a plus a bar is same as 1. So previously we have seen that if you have plotted the value of 1, you are seeing that all of the values of under the 1 is 1 only. That is why we have written a plus a bar is equal to 1. Now a into a bar is equal to 0. So a bar into a into a bar. So under a you have written 0, 1 and a bar is 1, 0. So if you multiply 0 into 1 is 0 and 1 into 0 is 0. That is why entire thing is 0. So in the previous table we have seen that under 0 there is only all of the values are 0 only. That is why a into a bar is equal to 0. Idempotent law. idempotent law says that a plus a is equal to a and a into a is equal to a. So under a I have written 0 1, and under a again I have written 0 1, since we have to write both of them. Now if you add the binary values of them, a plus a, so 0 plus 0 is 0 and 1 plus 1 is again 1. Always remember that for binary addition of truth table values, 0 plus 0 is your 0, 0 plus 1 is your 1, 1 plus 0 is your 1, and 1 plus 1 is again 1. That is why the 1 plus 1 is your 1 only. That is why, since they are same, so a plus a is equal to a. Now a into a is equal to a. A under a is written 0 1, under a is again 0 1. So if you multiply, 0 into 0 is 0 and 1 into 1 is 1. So a into a is equal to a. Now involution law. So involution law states that if a complement is done two times, that is double complement, you get the original value. So I have written a under 0, under that I have written 0 1, and a complement is 0 will become 1 and 1 will become 0. Now if you again complement this one, what you are getting, then we are seeing that 1 is becoming 0 and 0 is becoming 1. So basically we are seeing that the ultimate value, that is double complement of the number, is original value only. That is why a complement of whole complement is 1. So we will do up to here. In the next video we will just continue these laws and move on to the sum of product and product of sum, those kind of questions.